Alright, so we're back at Brian's Reptarium, where today we're going to connect and hook up his 800 or might even be 1,000 gallon pond for his large alligator snapper turtle. Alright, so we got a basic idea of all of the fittings that we need. You know, if you don't have a really good pet store handy right by, you got to know somebody special, and I think you got a pretty cool friend.
Yeah, I have a guy. I'm gonna go see if we can raid his place. I think he might be able to help us out.
We're here. Last time we were here, Steve was working on a new room. I want to see how far he's come.
Oh wow! I don't know if you guys remember this. A lot of this wasn't like this last time. All the tanks are in. Before it was just the stands.
I thought I had a lot of big tanks.
I think we got everything we need. Hose clamps, bulkheads. We've got to come up with a concoction to make all of this work, but lots of hose. You guys know I always have lots of hose. Hurry up, Steve.
What else do you need, boss? I got nothing else going on.
No, nothing. All right, Steve, thanks for letting us come spot through and save the day. Otherwise, I would have had to hang my head and go home with failure.
But if you guys want to check out what Steve does, you can go to bashsea.com. I'll leave a link in the description below. I highly recommend you check him out. I've been here before, so I'll leave a link in the description to that tour as well, even though I kind of showed you around and a few updated things. Make sure you check it out.
I'm going to start by disconnecting all of this old plumbing, reconnect, and start connecting the new stuff.
Looks like I'll just be able to remove the old tubing. We're going to continue to use these.
Don't need this. That's an input. 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 Yeah, so all this tubing just has to come off, and hopefully it'll just slide right off. Yeah. Now I repeat that several times. All right, all that temporary plumbing ripped out. I'm going to start over here. Start setting up some of these filters as well in advance. He's using Fluval FX6s, rated for aquariums up to about 400 gallons. He's got three of them, so he's got enough filtration for about 1,200 gallons of water. All three canister filters returns connected. These two are very basic. They're just getting returned up here. I'm going to show you where they're going in a moment. But the cool thing about this is if you have too much flow going to one waterfall, you can just kind of turn down the flow right here. They're a little stiff because they're brand new, but with these valves here. However, this one has to feed two waterfalls, so we had to split the return there. We can control the overall flow with this ball valve here, but then we have two more here to control the flow to each waterfall. Now all of these, this one here, comes up and comes out here. See that little hole there? So that's gonna come rushing down. Got a little rock here to direct the flow a little bit. The other one comes up under that flat, just cascading down. It's gonna look absolutely stunning. One of the canisters is going to come out here. It's going to fill up this bowl, cascade down to here, fill this up, cascade down to the bottom there. And then finally, if you see that little flap here, that's the last one there. That's going to all fill up. And I think it looks like it's going to cascade out at this side and this side. I hope both, because that would look absolutely amazing. Now, because he's going to have little pools of water, he can probably have some aquatic plants. Maybe even some tiny guppies of some sort. I don't know. What would you guys do? I guess we got to see this up and running to see what the waterfall looks like. But this is going to look awesome. I got to get in there now. Ouch. We have access to 5 1-inch holes. I think I'm going to access. One's already open. We're going to tap into that. And I think maybe I should stagger them so that all the suction's not in one place. But it does look like everything kind of tilts down this way, so maybe the suction should all be in one spot. Let's see which ones are loose and what we can do here. All these aren't even tight. Definitely want these nice and tight. We don't want to get this filled up, get a big alligator snapping turtle in here, only to have to come in and try to tighten these some more. You're looking good. Take a look back here before the water starts. We just tapped into the back there. Hose clamps. We're good to go. Brian? It's ready for water.
It's ready for water. Yeah. Ooh. We're going to go ahead and film up Bowser's Turtorarium. What'd you call it again?
It's an aquarium.
The terrarium?
It's an aquarium. You called it a turtlerarium.
We're going to fill up the turtlerarium. We're going to see if this sucker works. I am super excited about this. It may not look like much right now, but it's the start of something special.
This is going to look awesome. Especially with that turtle in it.
I can't wait to see these waterfalls. Because when we had the water filters going before, it was a loud pump. It was, you know, erratic, you know. So this is going to be so cool. I will warn you, though, the first time we turned the pump on, it shot up and almost hit the ceiling.
What?
But that was because we had the pump.
Oh, different type of pump. Yeah, these aren't going to be that powerful. But we can tune it all with all the valves that are installed. So you can have each waterfall do what you want, as long as nothing leaks.
So where do you think the water level will be? Probably like up to here or something.
Around there.
Like probably right to below this, so you can still hear the water falling? Oh yeah, definitely be below that, yeah. Okay. Yeah. So we can get a rough idea. It's 68 inches front to back. And then maybe here to here, 94. So 68 by 94. 68 by 94 by, let's say, 30. So if we multiply the length by height by width, we can get the cubic inches.
Mm-hmm.
Now there's 231 cubic inches to a gallon of water, so we multiply the length by height by width in inches divided by 231, and we will get the gallons. 830 gallons approximately. It's probably closer to 900 based on a lot of crevices and different areas we didn't measure. So there you have it, 900 gallons. We estimated like 700 to 800.
Getting close. Twice as much water and we can turn the filters on. Okay, all filters hooked up, enough water in it to turn them on. Plug them in. Got a screw in here. Now, of course, the filters are going to keep turning on and off as they purge the air. The flow of the waterfall is actually going to increase, most likely by tomorrow, probably be close to double this flow. But it's looking pretty awesome. We only have a few inches of water in it right now, but we can imagine what it's going to be like when it's absolutely full. So much more to do out here. But I guess we could take a look, see what things are going to look like when we walk in. You might even see, catch Brian vlogging. Never know. Check this out. I need something like this. This is absolutely stunning now. I just did the same shot you just did.
Yeah, okay. Sure.
If you could just keep filming and give me ideas, that'd be great.
All right, folks, that's it for the, what do we call it?
The Turtorarium.
The Turtorarium. I can't wait to someday come back, someday soon, and see it filled up. With the turtle in it, but for now I'm sure Brian will show you over on his channel. So if you want to see more of this aquarium, make sure you go over, check out his channel and subscribe. You certainly don't want to miss that when he transfers a massive, how many pounds is that, 40-50 pound alligator snapping turtle?
Almost 100.
Yeah, almost 100 pounds. Yeah. Good luck, I'm going home.
The snapping turtle.
Oh gosh, I can't believe I didn't shoot.
I wanted to see snakes, but now that I'm seeing snakes, I don't want to see snakes.
All right, let's go see. So obviously Joey's helping me out with the snapping turtle, so you gotta meet Bowser, the snapping turtle.
Oh, Bowser.
Eric, I'm gonna need your help,
yep,
man.
That's why I'm here. Watch
what, these arms. In here?
Yep.
He was in here?
Yep.
The whole time. So you got goldfish. What?
Eric, you want to grab him?
Just watch yourself.
No, yeah. No. Yeah, yeah. He is way bigger than he is on. Yeah, what? Right. Wait, yeah. Why is he doing that?
Because he wants to bite. Oh. Keep your hand away.
But don't let him.
Here, get the back. I'll get the front.
Okay.
Your hands are so close. Oh, God.
Deal?
Oh, he's trying. Oh. No, I don't want one of those.
This thing is so heavy. Sorry. Did he get you?
Oh.
Yeah, they can reach pretty far, so watch your camera there.
Oh, no, he's fine. You're fine.
He's so angry.
God, he's so strong.
Look at his mouth. It's disgusting.
Well, you know, see that little tongue in there?
Yeah, tongue is a lure.
You got him, Ryan?
Yep, I got him.
Okay.
His tongue is a lure.
What's he weigh, like 50 pounds?
Oh, he's like 70, 80 pounds.
70,
damn.
Yeah,
so in the when they're in the water, what do they, like, flick it out?
Yeah, so that little tongue right there actually looks like a lure. It looks like a worm. And then the fish go up thinking they're going to get a little dinner, and whack, that thing gets you.
Oh, damn.
It's crazy, huh?
What does he eat? What's his diet in the wild?
He mainly eats fish in the wild, but pretty much anything that gets in his mouth, he'll eat. We feed him rodents. We feed him some chicken sometimes, and then we feed him actually a crocodilian diet.
And these two get along just fine.
Yeah, they're from the same area in the wild. So they actually come from the same area. I'll be totally honest with you. RJ's not a big fan of Bowser.
Well, if he needs a break, he clearly can get out. How did he get down here? He just jumped?
He just climbed down. Yeah. So that's why we want to get Bowser his own tank, so that way he can hang out. RJ has his own tank again.
I'm not holding
him. And everyone's
him.
Real happy.
What's he? He just said, yeah, he feels like a turtle. Just like a turtle. Look at his claws.
It's crazy. I'll tell you what, those claws are the worst part, to be honest with you. When you're holding onto him, he'll dig in like this.
Oh, listen to it, yeah.
And he, oh, my leg's getting a little close.
You still good?
We're good. So anyways, so you got some goldfish.
Yeah, goldfish are his friends. We put those in here thinking that he might want to eat them.
It doesn't look like it. I think they're too small for him to be interested.
Yeah, he had no interest in them at all.
Oh my god. I've had enough. What is that? There's too many big animals here.
Oh,
I'm just back.
So RJ just jumps when he needs a break. He's just like parkour, jumps out. Is that what he does?
Yeah, pretty much, man. He goes for it.
This is actually a Burmese python named Snaz.
Yeah, oh, that's just the baby.
He's
isn't
gonna
it?
Go over next door as well. What's up, Snazzy?
Is he hissing?
Yeah, a little bit.
Or am I hearing things?
No, he's hissing a little
am
bit.
Am I already scared?
Yeah.
Oh, he is Snazzy. Hissing.
Oh, yeah, he's hissing.
He's going to bite me, isn't he?
Maybe. It's always possible.
Well, okay. Well back here I go.
Just think of the clickbait.
No, that's cool. Real cool guy.
Joey goes to the hospital. This is BHB. Ends up in emergency. Hey, we're really hospitable here at BHB.
Oh,
you know?
Yeah. Oh,
we always want to make sure
that's
everyone's
not even,
right.
That's
we
not
want
even.
To, we want you to have the best experience, hands-on experience you can.
So anyways, the Reptarium's pretty cool if you guys want to see that.
Joey, I'm not done with you.
It's enough.